The Mythbusters have come out all guns blazing. They've been testing what is bulletproof. And that's got Jamie thinking.
You know, I was thinking.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. I was thinking that we've got so much stuff laying around this shop that we could roust something up that is not terribly exotic that we could make bulletproof armor out of.
Homegrown bulletproof. I love that. You've already got some ideas, I'll bet.
Oh, yeah.
All right, I reckon I could come up with something. Let's do it.
So with their myths checked off, Jamie's issued a challenge. Can the Mythbusters build a slug stopper out of everyday materials? Well, first up is Adam, and he reaches straight for, custard?
This is just cornstarch and water, and it's known in science circles as a non-Newtonian fluid. And I'm thinking its property of acting sometimes like a solid and sometimes like a liquid.
As illustrated to perfection in the Ninja Special. When Adam's son jumped on the cornstarch, it immediately hardened, so it supported his weight. When he stood still, he sank like a stone. But will it be strong enough and act fast enough to stop a bullet? Meanwhile, in the other corner, Jamie's forgone custard and focused on soda. Well, the can, at least.
What I'm noticing as I crush this can is that it's getting progressively more resistant to me crushing it.
So by crushing it to the max, will it roadblock around?
I don't really think it's going to stop a bullet by itself, but what if I have a whole bunch of them?
So while Jamie compacts cans, Adam's ready to test his corn flour mix.
Homegrown, bulletproof, one layer in 3, 2, 1.
Can the custard cut the mustard?
Oh, I definitely went through the aluminum. One layer is clearly not enough.
Having beaten his aluminum cans into submission, Jamie adds a dash of homebrew glue to the mix, known domestically as FGR95 cement.
Okay, that's one down. That's FGR95 and propylene fiber with aluminum cubes.
Adam amps up his testing. It's now a 2-custard cluster to fire at.
In 3, 2, 1. 2 layers still doesn't look like enough.
Meanwhile, Jamie's ready to point the Glock at the soda can block.
Firing in 3, 2, 1.
Does that look like...
That's the...
Did you catch it?
I caught the bullet right in the face of it. There it is.
So Jamie's first prototypes left him feeling pumped, while Adam's feeling pressure. In desperation, he maxes his mix up to 6 layers of custard.
6 layers! Going for broke. 3, 2, 1. Nothing.
Looks like the same size bullet hole.
So cornstarch as a bulletproof material? Dud, dud, dud.
3.
Meanwhile, Jamie's testing has now shown that cement with fiber in cans is okay at stopping a 9mm.
It collapsed the aluminum, but it did not make it through.
But he wants more, and a sudden restroom renovation revelation delivers the solution.
Even though I'm kind of attached to my recycled aluminum cans, I'm gonna try these tiles. They're hard. I think they might break up a bullet, and they come ready to go in these nifty little sheets, just like armor plates.
They test it out and...
3, 2.
What do you know? The bullet bounces straight off.
Jamie, it didn't make it through the felt.
I wondered.
Yeah.
So that worked.
It did.
Rather predictably, it's Jamie who wins this challenge. But how will his bunch of blocks fare when they get put to the ultimate test?
Let's get out to the shooting range.
This is my improvised armor. Now, it's made of a high-strength gypsum cement called FGR95, which is filled with polypropylene fiber. And we've also inserted 2 layers of common bathroom tiles a little bit back from the front.
With its gel vital organs as backstop, the mannequin will take the hit if the tile proves permeable.
Well, here at the Mythbusters Armory, Jamie said he wanted to test the Jamie tile. We wanted to give it a good solid test. We chose wide bandwidth
of your basic armaments and ammunition. So let me give you a tour of today's arsenal. Starting off with the handgun 9mm, moving on to the handgun 45 caliber, then to the shotgun, both with the buckshot and the deer slug, finally finishing off with a high-speed rifle round, the 223. That ought to give this thing a run for its money.
Lights going hot!
And suited, locked, and loaded for the first big test, let's pause for a prediction from Jamie.
As far as pistols go, the 9mm has a reputation for penetrating quite well. I'm going to go out on a limb here, though, and say, I think my Jamie tile's going to stop it.
But will confidence be confirmed by the conclusion?
Firing in 3, 2, 1. It stopped it.
It totally stopped it. There you go.
It's a 9mm.
I'd say it's Jamie Tile 1, bullet 0.
It's a good start for Jamie's tile. But next, it's staring down the barrel of a 45 handgun.
Oh, that looks like a nice stop. Beauty.
Hardly a dent in the back.
Jamie Tile 2, bullets, zilch.
Next up in the ramp up, it's buckshot.
After watching what it did against the handgun rounds, I don't think buckshot's gonna make it through the Jamie Tile. Wow! Look at that.
Well, I tell you what, buckshot is one of the scariest things you can go up against, and the Jamie Tile stopped it, and stopped it cold.
But now things get really serious as buckshot takes a backseat, replaced by the deer slug.
And this is almost an ounce of lead. It's a huge amount of force coming out of that gun. I don't know whether we'll be able to stop it or not.
Hot, right here, protection on.
I see dead people.
And the fears are founded.
Wow, look at that hole.
You'd be hurting.
You'd be dead.
The deer slug went straight through the tile and took out the vital organs, too.
Oh, it looks like the champion's been taken down by an upstart named Deer Slug.
And after the slow-moving but deadly deer shot,
now we're gonna move on to the 223. This is the opposite end of the scale. It's a really small bullet, but it's moving really, really fast.
But can it take out a Jamie Tile?
Range is hot, pioneers.
And it's the last man standing.
What do you think? You think it went through?
I think it went through.
You do? Oh, look at that.
There's the bullet. That would be a kill.
Wow, look at that. You certainly slowed that bullet down for it to end up in the gel, but he's dead.
And there's no arguing with that.